50 million years ago, they roamed our planet. Now, they roam the wealthy's living rooms and guest houses. Dinosaur fossils have become quite the status symbol among the elite. And in October of 2020, a T-Rex fossil was auctioned for $32 million, making it by far the most expensive dino display ever sold. And it doesn't stop there. More and more private collectors, including Leonardo DiCaprio and Nicolas Cage, are trying to cash in on these skeletons. And unfortunately, that may leave no dinos left for museums and the scientific community. We've got the story right here as we talk about the most expensive fossil ever sold and how this affects your next trip to the museum. So, how is it that a T-Rex fossil sold for such a colossal amount of money? Well, to answer that, we gotta talk a bit about this particular tyrannosaur and what makes it so special. This fossilized Rex was actually quite famous before its million-dollar purchase. It was known as Stan, due to the fact that the paleontologist who discovered him was named Stan Sackerson. Mr. Sackerson found this rare fossil in 1987, and at first, the bones were misclassified as a triceratops, which is a much more common find out there in the wild. But after a second opinion from scientists 5 years later, they realized this was the king of the dinos, the real deal, the favorite of kids and adults everywhere. This was the mighty T-Rex, which, believe it or not, is one of the reasons that Stan was so pricey. T-Rex fossils are incredibly rare, and worldwide, only about 50 have ever been discovered. On top of that, Stan was in tip-top shape, and after a lofty 30,000 hours of excavating this ancient carnivore, Stan was placed in Black Hills Institute of Geological Research in Hills City, South Dakota, where he was billed as one of the most complete dino skeletons in the world. His skull is in almost perfect condition, and in total, this fossilized display contains 188 bones. In fact, Stan is in such good shape, he has been used as the model for T-Rex toys, figures, models, and drawn depictions. Basically, Stan was the real deal, and collectors certainly took notice. Due to all these incredible factors, this 67 million year old fossil caught the ear of many wealthy private curators. And when Stan went up for auction on October 6th, 2020, his sale price absolutely demolished the initial estimate of $6 to $8 million. When it was all said and done, an anonymous buyer over the telephone bid $31.85 million and won. That means Stan sold for four times the estimated amount. Even outside the world of collecting dinosaur bones, that's still impressive. Now, Stan will be displayed in Christie's Rockefeller Center in New York City. But this is by no means the usual final resting place for similar dino bones. In fact, many purchases like this aren't able to be viewed by the public, which brings us to a very real problem with the buying and selling of these incredible scientific discoveries. See, the wealthy love dinos. And you know what? We can't blame them. Who didn't love Jurassic Park? This blockbuster made $1.03 billion at the box office, so clearly there's an interest. But if you think that's impressive, get this. Its recent sequel, Jurassic World, made $1.67 billion at the box office. Yeah, look, dinosaurs are just cool. So, as you can imagine, due to a spike in popularity of dinos because of Steven Spielberg's masterpiece, museums started buying up all the dinos they could. Just months after 1997's The Lost World was released, the sequel to Jurassic Park, a 12-meter-long T-Rex sold for $8.63 million. Nowadays, it's all about how famous a dino is. The more famous, the more it costs. After all, today, a Triceratops skull can go for $170,000 to $400,000, while Diplodocus goes for $570,000 to $1.1 million. And the average T-Rex? Yeah, they're going for about $10 million. This kind of rarity has attracted the attention of Leonardo DiCaprio, Nicolas Cage, and even Russell Crowe. They have all expressed interest in dino collecting. But here's the catch. scientists think that all this scooping up of rare fossils can actually be detrimental to the scientific community. As put by Michigan University's Jerry Smith, when specimens go into a private home or collection, our understanding, interpretation, or discovery of new information they contain will never reach the scientific community. In fact, just last year, the U.S. Society of Vertebrate Paleontology reached out to the Parisian auction house Agout and requested that they cancel a sale of a 29-foot-long dinosaur. Their reasoning? This dino wasn't yet identified, and if it was put into a private collector's home, then there would be no chance for experts to learn from this incredible find. Too bad for the winner, as they reportedly paid $2.3 million for the mystery fossil. Speaking of canceled purchases, in 2013, Nicolas Cage, an avid collector of many things including first edition comics, had spent $267,000 on a 67 million year old skull of a Tyrannosaurus Bitar. He had won the skull in an auction and beat out other high bids from famous friends including Leonardo DiCaprio. But here's where things get a little messy. The skull was obtained by Eric Procopi. Procopi was infamous for previously pleading guilty for illegally importing fossils from across the globe, from places like Mongolia and China. Mr. Cage unfortunately had to give his new Tyrannosaur skull back, and it was returned to Mongolia. But let's be clear, scientists aren't urging people not to collect, but rather to be wary of seeking out unique specimens. There's still a ton of research that can be done on these rare finds, and if these fossils are swept up by billionaires with a love of dinos, well, then we all lose. Nothing good comes from a dino skeleton sitting in a living room collecting dust, when it could be being studied. All in all, we have to say, we're not at all surprised that dino bones have become quite the trendy commodity among the 1%. These specimens are rare, are unique, and are freaking dinosaurs. Of course you would want to have one in your home, if you had the money. Who wouldn't? And there seems to be no sign of wealthy collectors stopping scooping up these priceless fossils, so best to run to your nearest museum of natural history and catch these magnificent scientific discoveries while you still can. We don't want to be the arbiters of doom and gloom, but the truth is, these fossils could go extinct again. From the public. Hey, thanks for sticking around and watching today's video. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button. It helps us out here so much, and it allows us to continue to make you all the content you love involving the richest. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing. We'll keep you up to date on all the goings-on of the wealthy and well-off. We'll see you next time.